Well, it means there's going to be longer waiting times, and this is concerning with COVID cases rising. Officials say in mid-June, they were responding to just under 10 COVID-related calls a day here in Oklahoma City. Now that's jumped up to 30 to 40 calls a day.
There's no more important issue for us right now as an agency than improving our staffing numbers.
Adam Palooka with IMSA tells me staffing isn't just an issue here in the metro or even Oklahoma. It's now a national one.
By 2030, there's expected to be about 42,000 fewer EMTs and paramedics than what will be needed in the United States. And that's according to the Health Resources and Services Administration.
He says they can't pinpoint an exact reason for the shortage, but he does say the trend started years ago with fewer people showing interest in the job. That's why they're taking a different approach for the hiring process.
We've launched a brand new recruiting website, joinemsa.com. We had 1,000 hits in the first 4 weeks of that. We're also offering our highest ever signing bonuses for paramedics, $20,000. And $10,000 for dispatchers. We've improved the starting base pay for EMTs.
Palooka tells me IMSA's Western Division, which Oklahoma City falls under, has 69 paramedics able to work right now. Their goal is to have 113, but they do have ideas to boost staffing in the meantime.
We're also going to bring in about 80 system-credentialed firefighters to work as transport medics on our units. That's going to start in 2 weeks.
They're also looking to get approval to have a basic life support ambulance respond to certain calls rather than an advanced life support ambulance.
We think that there could be about maybe 22,000 calls a year where a BLS unit could respond instead of an ALS unit.
And I'm told they're looking into improving retention efforts, giving employees who have been here longer than 7 months a $1,000 bonus. They're also looking to improve rest and recovery breaks as well. Reporting live tonight, Paris Jones, KOCO 5 News.